Hi everyone, and welcome to the What's New in Sound Particles 2 series of tutorials. In this video, I'm going to give you a quick overview of this software. Sound Particles is a 3D native audio application that uses computer graphics techniques applied to sound. By implementing concepts such as particle systems and computer graphics integration, it can easily create thousands of complex sounds in a fast and innovative way. I know it sounds complicated, but it actually isn't. Let's take a look. When you open Sound Particles, there's a list of templates. This may be a good starting point for your projects, or you can start from scratch. We have included some examples such as Doppler. In this video, you can see the particle moving in relation to this blue dot, which is the microphone. Let's hear the original sound. And let's hear the result of the render. We also have included templates with more particles. Let's hear it. For this example, I want to use an empty project. Here we have the 3D views. This is where the particles will be seen and will be interacting with the microphone. In order to add particles to this 3D space, we can add an audio track, which can be mono, stereo, or ambisonics. We can add a particle group, which is a particle system where all particles start at the same time, or we can even add a particle emitter, which emits particles at a certain rate. For this example, let's use a particle group. By default, a particle group starts with 100 particles, but we can go up to 1000 and even up to 100,000. Let's keep it simple and go back to 100 particles. We can even change the shape of the particle group. We have rectangles, we have circles, and we also have surface of spheres. Let's use this one for this example. Now we can add movement modifiers. Let's start by adding a straight line velocity. As you can see, each particle is moving in a straight line with random velocities. You can change the type of randomization using these buttons here. Next, to add some variation, we can add an audio modifier. For instance, we can add a random delay. What will happen is that each particle will start with a random delay between 0 and 2 seconds. But we can go and change it for 5 seconds. We can also change the position of the group by using the 3D manipulator. Now that we have our particle system ready, let's import some audio files. We have imported 55 audio files. What will happen is that each particle will randomly select one of these files and reproduce it. In order to render this scene, we need to add a microphone. By default, the microphone is a stereo microphone, but it can be mono, can be ambisonics up to 6th order, it can be a multi-channel, 5.1, 7.1, IMAX, Dolby Atmos. You choose. For this example, let's use a stereo mic. You can also change the position of the mic using the 3D manipulator. Now, there's two ways of rendering this scene. You can render it online or offline, depending on the complexity of the scene. For this one, let's render it online. To do so, we have to make sure this tick is on and we just need to press play. And keep in mind, you can render any project with more than one track and more than one microphone. As you can see, the microphone rendered each particle in terms of their distance by attenuating the sound, in terms of direction by applying panning, and in terms of Doppler effects. Now that our render is ready, let's export it. Here, you can choose the microphone you want to render. You can choose if you want an interleaved or non-interleaved file, the file format, the bit depth, and the order of the channels. You can also include metadata, and you can change it by simply ticking the box you want to edit. Now, we just need to select a folder where we want to place this render. And here we go, your first render. And that was it. Thank you all for watching. Follow us on social media if you want to keep up with the news. For more tutorials like this one, subscribe to our YouTube channel. I hope to see you in the next video. And don't forget, always unleash your creativity with sound particles.